Hello friends, welcome back to the course of ICT for IES 2019. In the previous two videos, we have discussed some important points of fourth chapter of ICT. So those four points were objectives of ICT, continuum of approach, ICT in schools, and ICT enables teaching learning process we have discussed so far. So in this video, we are going to see ICT for open and distance learning. So why this is so important to learn ICT for open and distance learning? So friends, distance learning has come to come in possible, like real, or it is possible just because of ICT. So ICT plays a main key role in the distance learning and the open learning, we can say. So this is one of the most important thing that we will have to discuss, and ICT for school management. So where and how do we use ICT for school management, we are going to see in this video. So let's get started. So ICT for open and distance learning. So open and distance learning is getting more dependent on ICT and has been playing an important role in this delivery of strategies for distance learning. With the advancement in technology in the field of education, this introduced variety of new technologies for educators and the learners. So yes, the traditional method don't have that much of advancement. So because of ICT, there has been abundant, we can say at a large, very large extent, there is advancement in the studies for teachers as well as the learners. So educational technologies are replacing direct teachers, teacher-student interaction. Yes, this is, we can say, we can take it as a positive, but as well as a negative point. This is reducing the teaching teacher-learner interaction. Since if the students want to get some information about some topic, it can he or she can directly go and access the internet service, and he will get the detailed knowledge or detailed information about that topic. So he would not approach the teacher. So in some way, this is reducing the teaching teacher and learner interaction, we can say. So anything that helps distance learning approach to communicate. That is, for example, this might be the, we can take it as a negative as well as positive, because there were so many students, those who did not have access or did not, they were not able to have education, or they were not being able to approach the teachers directly. So this has been the really game changer for those students. So anything that helps distance learners to communicate, that is learner with instructor, learner with learner, and learner with learning material, that may be termed as information technology, since it is having something information and it is being delivered by using technology. So technological advancements, especially in the area of ICT, allows the teacher to employ various strategies that could actively engage the students' interest. So let's go and see how different authors have defined the technology based education. So the Moore's definition of distance education. So the Moore's definition of distance education is the separation between a learner and teacher, such that the communication between two is necessary in the educational transition, that is transmitted through print broadcasting, telecommunication media, correspondence, institution, through mail, audio and video recordings, computer, and various combination of variations of the things. So this was the definition given by Murray for distance education. So this involves a delivery, this can be explained as the delivery of learning or teaching to those who are separated mostly by time and distance. So even if some student is separated from school by time or distance, he would be able to take gain the knowledge, or he would be able to access all the same knowledge, the same information, by using the use of ICT. So the teaching is done with variety of mediating process used to transmit content, to provide tuition, and to conduct assessment or measure outcomes. So this was the definition given by Murray. So let's go and see what how NEPA in 1989 has defined the distance education, distance learning. So this was the first to suggest that distance learning was moving into its third generation. So as so far as mobile generations, we can say first generation, second generation, third generation. So this person has introduced the word third generation for the distance learning. So referring to correspondence education as a first generation, the model of distance learning and multimedia distance education as the second generation, and the distance learning as the third one. In these models, little or no student to student and student to interaction occurs. So this is the way in which he has described the first generation, second generation, and the third generation of learning. So in the, he has said that in the third generation of learning, there is very less or no student to student and student to teacher interaction. So third generation of distance education, also known as interactive multimedia distance education, places an emphasis on the communication and learning as social process typically through the education of interactive media such as computer, the medium for this is basically computer and the computer systems or mobile phones. So audio graphics and video conferencing, this is the thing. The third generation of distance education based on use of information technology, completely use of information technology. Since there is no student to student interaction, there is no student to teacher interaction, it is all about the person, the student, and the system. So this was the definition given by NEPA in 1989. So let's go and see how Taylor has further developed NEPA's ideas. So with the combination of interactive multimedia, access to www resources, we have seen so far in the previous video what exactly www is, and the asynchronous computer conferencing being designated as a fourth generation, and flexible learning model. So in the video conferencing, we can say if it is not recorded on the record, then it is real time, nothing but real time communication it was, but the recording kept on online, we can say this would be the fourth generation, and this was so explained by the Taylor. So emerging fourth generation of distance education, the flexible learning model promises to combine benefits of high quality interactive multimedia with the access to increasingly extensive range of teaching learning resources and enhanced interactive through the computer mediated communication offered by connection to the internet. If you do have the connection, internet connection to your system, you can directly go to website www and you can put whatever the information you want. You can get all the information relevant to that topic. So this comes under, and this is not the real time. This is completely off time. Like this is not real time communication. Like video conferencings are generally real time. No, so this is on record, and you can have access to it at any time. So these were the four definitions so far. The technology is nothing but an enabling tool, and it is destruction of course into its core experiences and communication to students regardless of its delivery mechanism that is crucial. So this was explained by Kobel in 1996. This was explained by this scientist in all about the distance learning. So the technology which can be integrated into the distance education system based on our experiences, the following factors should be considered. So yes, for the establishment of distance learning, this four factors have to be considered. Those are accessibility, cost effectiveness, human acceptance, and pedagogical suitability. So all this four things, they are not needed to be explained so far, and since this is something that is needed for any student to get access, the system should be accessible, it should be cost effective, it should not be very costly, and it should be human friendly, or you can say student friendly, so that they would easily accept it, and it should be suitable as well. So this was all about the first thing, the first half of this video, So in the second half of this video, we are going to see ICT for school management part. How the ICT has been used for school management. There are so many things in a school to be, like the things should be organized. There are so many records that has to be stored. And for management of all those things, how ICT has been used nowadays. So this is what we are going to see in this second half part of video. So the information and communication technology plays a vital role in supporting powerful, efficient management and administration in education sector. So it is specified that technology can be used right from the student administration to various resource administration in the educational institution. So here in the chart, there are some like categories. How the students administration has been using the ICT, and there are some different concepts and their content categories where the ICT has been used. So usage of electronic media by students to apply for admission at the student side. If you want to get admitted to some school, you can get the admission forms, you can fill the admission forms online. Use of computers for student registration, enrollment, you can do the enrollment to that school online. Availability of timetable, yes, students are nowadays having all the information about this course syllabus online. Use of computers for maintenance of attendance of students. Communication of academic details of students to their parents through e-media, like whatever the test has been conducted, the results of all the tests could be sent to their parents by email. Use of e-media for notification regarding hostel accommodation and regarding transportation. Everything, every possible thing by use of ICT comes under this. Next is how staff administration. That was all about how students would be taking advantage, how student management was there. This is about the staff administration. So use of computers for recruitment and work allotment of staff in the institution. So far students part has been covered. So for recruitment of staff as well as their allotment, their accommodation, everything that that is concerned with the staff, that would come under this point. Automation of attendance and leave management of staff members in the institution. So nowadays everything is online. We can do everything by using some online process. So even the leave management for staff has been done online. Use of electronic media for performance appraisal to appraise your staff for whatever the good work that they have done. All these things could be done online nowadays. Then communication with staff using e-media. Then e-circulators from institution regarding official matters and whatever, all the things that are available that could be done online are nowadays done online. So then general administration is use of e-media for scheduling and accumulation, allocation of halls for examination. All the administrative part, for example, management of classrooms, management of halls for examinations. Then use of students to apply for university examination. Then e-media for processing and display of results of students. Facility for students to make fee payments electronically. Everything has been made online. And this was all about how the ICT has been included in all these things. So now let us go and see what is the importance of school records. So there are so many records the school has that has to be like kept in order, and there are so many reasons for that. So how ICT helps in this, we are going to see. So school records keeping includes fact that school records tell the story of school, the story of the students that have passed through that school, then the historical resources that the school has, facility continuity in the administration and management of school. Then there are so many things. We will just go and read out these things. So provide information needed on ex-students by higher and other related institution and employer of labor for admission and placements. facilitate the supply of information to parent and guardian for effective monitoring of progress of their children in the school performance. And like teacher student interaction, there must be the record of student that has to be kept in order. So how ICT helps in this is the most important thing, that administrative efficiency and easy retrieval. For example, if the records of students has been kept in Word, Excel, so it is really very easy for the administrative or whoever the person is, whoever the staff is, to get access to the information by directly going to the information of that student. So it is really very convenient as compared to classical approach. So scheduling, there is school calendar, there are softwares that help to design the school timetables and to keep the records. There are so many softwares available online. So we'll discuss some of the timetable generating softwares here. So the first one is FET, that is free evolutionary timetabling. This is basically the software that could be like installed on Ubuntu, that is Linux operating system. So automatictimetable.com, this is ASC timetable, that is fully automated school timetable scheduling software. So links I have put in here so that you will be able to go and see how exactly these softwares work. The next is which comes under proprietary software whose trial version for Windows and Macs are also available. So these are the free softwares that are being used for generating these school timetables. So communicating with parents, yes, this is the most like usable thing for school like point of view. So to communicate with the parents by email, by messaging, by through internet, there are so many things that has made this possible, that improve the student teacher and parent interaction. So website and blog, yes, whatever the information of the class that is available on website, or that could be put in on the blogs or something. Online survey forms, the teachers can send the survey forms to the parents so that they could be able to get whatever the feedback of the teacher parents is. Virtual learning environment, then this is the software that creates the virtual learning environment. Then media sharing, social networks, online groups and forums, SMS and instant messaging, Google Chrome extension and apps. So these are so many, there are so many ways through which the teacher and parent could communicate by using ICT. School management tools, that is Fikara, school time, then TA School, Fedena, Ascend SMS, School Tool, Open Admin for schools. These are the school management tools. So far in this video, we have covered the most important parts of this complete unit. That is, we have seen how ICT has been used in school management. So we will continue with the chapter in the next video. Thank you.